On the 11th of September, the world marked 18 years since the twin attacks on New York's World Trade Centers, a pivotal moment in modern history that ushered in almost two decades of war in Iraq and Afghanistan and a slew of emergency anti-terrorism legislation. My perspective guest today is a man who's deeply skeptical about the individual liberties trade-off we seem to have made in the name of national security. Raphael Kempf, a lawyer at the Paris Bar. Welcome to France 24. You're the author of a book hot off the press, called Enemies of the State, Les Lois Scélérates, or the Villainous Laws, From Anarchists to Terrorists. Thank you for coming on to speak to us about the book today.
Thank you.
Could you please start by telling us exactly what these Lois Scélérates are, for those of us who don't know?
Okay. Historically, these Villainous Laws have been made at the end of the 19th century in France, in 1983-94, and they were directed against the anarchists and not against the attacks or terror attacks the anarchists could have made, but against the freedom of expression and against the anarchist as a political ideology. So on behalf, on the name of the struggle against an attack, these laws are targeting the opinion and the freedom of expression. And in this book, I found old texts, old articles written by, for example, the former Prime Minister of France, Léon Blum, in the 30s. And this man, at the end of the 19th century, he has written a very good article against these laws. And I think that his article can also be read today to understand the situation we are facing with these laws made against terrorism, but in fact which are targeting something else.
And these laws were ushered in very quickly after a specific incident at the National Assembly in France.
Exactly. In 1893, it was a Saturday, a young anarchist was throwing a bomb in the House of Parliament. There were no people died, only small injuries among the Member of Parliament. But 2 days later, it was on the Monday, the government came to the House and asked the Member of Parliament to pass a law which is directed against the freedom of expression of anarchists. And the government said, okay, there is this event, I need a new law to fight against this anarchist. But in fact, this new law was fighting against the ideology of the anarchist, a political ideology, and not against the act of throwing a bomb in a parliament, for example.
So in your opinion, in your book, you explain that this is by no means a 19th century phenomenon. Very similar things are happening today.
Exactly. For example, in France, we had this terrific terror attack in 2015, in January and then in November. And after both of these attacks, the French government passed legislations which are against, not terrorists, but against people that the government think that they could become terrorists at one time. And for example, the state of emergency, which has been passed in France in November 2015, it has been used not against terrorists, but very quickly against, for example, political activists, against ecologists, against environmentalists, against people wanting to go to a demonstration. So what we see with these Villainous Laws is that they are made against the enemy, they are made against the terrorist, but they are very quickly targeting all of the citizens and, for example, the protesters, the demonstrators, ecologists, activists. And that's a problem.
And are there any circumstances in which you believe it is justified for a government to declare a state of emergency?
I don't think that a state of law, a democracy, could declare a state of emergency. I think that there is in the common laws all the tools to fight terrorism. And the state of emergency laws are not made against terrorism, but they are made to reassure the public opinion, for example, and the public. And the government need to show that he is doing something, in fact, when there is a terror attack.
But isn't there a need for the public to be reassured? Isn't that actually quite useful in a democracy?
That need cannot be at the expense of the rights of the citizens. And that's what we've seen with these laws. It's we are reacting, the government is reacting, but soon we lose liberties, we lose freedoms, and not only some people, but all of us. And we've seen that with the Yellow Vest movement since 1 year. The Yellow Vests have been targeted and punished on the basis of laws which have been adopted, passed just after September 11 in France. So we are applying today a law made against terrorism after September 11, and we are applying these laws to protesters of the Yellow Vest movement. So this is an example how the liberties and freedoms of all the citizens are being attacked by these laws, these so-called anti-terror laws.
Raphael Kempf, author of Enemies of the State, Villainous Laws from Anarchists to Terrorists. Thank you very much indeed for coming on to speak to us here on France 24.